In this session, we're going to show you how to use Spinitron. This is the website that KBVR-FM uses to log its music and report it out to listeners and to labels. This is a great way for listeners to see what you are playing on your show and get a better sense of what your show is like. Here's how you use it. First things first, you need to go to Spinitron.com and click on the Login button in the top right corner. It's going to take you to this page. This is actually an older login page. We use version 2. The link to that is down here at the bottom. So login for Spinitron V2. Click on that. Login using your Oregon State email. I'm going to skip over this so you don't steal my identity. When you log in, you're going to see your welcome screen. It's going to show you your KBVR-FM DJ name that you selected for yourself. If you uploaded a photo into your profile, you'll see that there. It'll show you the upcoming shows on KBVR-FM, all the things that are currently scheduled on KBVR-FM, and it shows you the recent playlists that you have done on the air, the recent songs that you've played and the shows that you have done. In this case, it's showing all the DJ training shows that I've done in October and December. So when you're ready to create a playlist, which is the list of music that you are putting on the air, you're going to come up to Playlist, and new. You're making a new playlist for every show that you do. Even if you do a show every week, each week is going to have a new playlist. So you're always going to make a new playlist. When you're in here, it lists all of the different DJs. And you can search by DJ name as well, or your real name. So when you select your name, it'll show you all of the shows that you have currently scheduled. Now, I'm not a student, so I don't have a scheduled show. But if you are, for example, I know that DJ OK has a show coming up, and it'll show you his scheduled show. You would click on that, and you would go into your playlist editor. If you don't have a scheduled show, you're just popping into the booth to play some tunes one day because it's open, that's OK too. You would click Use Blank Playlist. No matter if you click Use Blank Playlist or select a show that's already scheduled, it's going to look the same. So don't worry if you're not clicking on one or the other. It's all going to come out the same in the end. So for our purposes, I'm going to click on Use Blank Playlist. When you go to Use Blank Playlist, you're going to give your playlist a name. So I'm just going to call it Test Spinitron. Under Category, you can select the type of show that you're doing. Music, college, electronic, hip-hop, news, talk, and sport, which is the British way of saying sports. So I'm just going to select music for right now. You need to select the date of your show, so I'm going to select today. And the start time. If you're doing this live, you're going to set it for the time when you go into the booth, which would be about 9 a.m. right now. Or you can build your playlist ahead of time for a show later. You can set it to 11 a.m., 11 p.m., whenever your show is, you can build all this ahead of time, which is okay. Most people do it live, so that's what we're going to show you today. So 9 a.m., duration in minutes. So if you have an hour-long show, you're going to type 60 minutes. Your DJ name is listed there. And then you can give your show a little extra description if you want. Right? You can give it a little something. Come down to the bottom and hit Submit. When you do that, it's going to take you into your music logging screen. This is the screen you're going to use most often because you need to manually put in the songs that you're playing during your show. If you ever go to kbvr.com, you'll notice at the very top of the screen, it shows the song that's currently playing. That's not just a nice thing for our listeners. We're legally required to do that by the RIAA. It's part of our license for playing music and streaming online. So you need to make sure you log your music in real time. But Spinitron gives you some very easy ways to do that. So let's say you're live on the air, you pop a CD in, and you start to play. You're going to come to Spinitron, and you're going to type in the name of the artist. A lot of artists are already populated in there, which makes it nice and easy. But you can also type it in manually. You're also going to put in the song. Let's say A Hard Day's Night. Hey, there it is right there. Composer, you don't need to worry about. And then release is the name of the album. And so you're playing it from the Hard Day's Night album. Select that. It even spits out a little cover for you, which is nice. If you were doing this live, you would then hit submit. And that song would populate live on Spinitron. Anyone who was listening to your show live on the air or is streaming it on the website would see it updated with the song that's currently playing. That's typically what most DJs are going to do. But a great feature about Spinitron is that you can do all of this work ahead of time before you even get into the booth. And you do that by hitting the Q button instead of Submit. By hitting Q, it puts your song in the list, but notice under timestamp, it doesn't have a time yet. It's not there. You can continue to add songs into your playlist. So let's add something else. Let's go Bob Dylan, just listening to him the other day. Go Shelter from the Storm, which is from Blood on the Tracks. And I'm gonna cue that up as well. Notice now it's going to continue to put these songs in the order that you populate it in. You can continue to add songs on here. Go with Rolling Stones, Satisfaction, why not? Release, again, on album, it's not necessarily important, especially if you're playing it as a single from your computer or your mobile device. Try to make sure that you select the correct album, but in this case, I may just have bought it as a single off of iTunes, and I don't remember what album it's on, so I'm just gonna do my best, select which one it is. So now that I have songs in the playlist that are queued up, I can do all that ahead of time so that when the show comes, I don't have to worry about typing in every single thing. I can just pop the CD in or start the song, and when I'm ready, just hit now. And now it's in the playlist. Now it's logged on Spinitron so people can see that. And when that song's over, we go to the next one, I'll hit now on that. And when that song's over, we go to the next one, we'll hit now on that. So that's how you can queue up a playlist ahead of time and continue to go song by song by song and not have to worry about rushing to fill in all of this information when you're in the middle of doing a show. Makes it very easy. That's about it when it comes to Spinitron. When you're done with your show, you always make sure that you log out. Well, that's it for Spinitron. Hope that helps, and have a good show.